Andrew Goodwin's Theory on Music Videos by Conor Gormley. In 1992, Andrew Goodwin disclosed his theories and observations about popular mainstream music videos in his popular book, Dancing in the Distraction Factory. In order to serve as both an insight into the workings and theories behind successful music videos and to serve as something of a guide for those of the future, Goodwin's theories are illustrated in countless prominent works both before and after his book. For example, Goodwin claims that there are a multitude of genre characteristics that can be traced through throughout the videos of that genre, something that can be seen in classic rock videos such as Bon Jovi's It's My Life or Living on a Prayer, and Queen's Bohemian Rhapsody. Aside from the psychedelia of the latter, a touch which nicely amplifies the somewhat surreal nature of the song's pacing and melodies, making use of a wide array of bright contrasting colours to create a sense of dissonance, something which is alien and strange, the video mostly features the band performing, and the same is true of Bon Jovi's video. This is most likely the focus on the great musical skill of the artists, as classical rock is infamously difficult to play, and draw attention to the distinctive fashion of the artists in the period, which was especially unique during the genre's heyday. Composing of tight-fitting clothes, long, wild and unkempt hair, the use of furs, leather and latex, as well as copious amounts of mascara on men. Rock music also has its fair share of over-the-top personalities. The genre is dominated by figures like Lemmy Kilmister from Motorhead, Slash from Guns N' Roses, Gene Simmons from Kiss, in fact anyone from Kiss. All these figures have their own distinctive personalities, fashion sense and style of playing, all of which gives them a kind of star status, one that makes them instantly recognisable to fans of that genre, and they are arguably more distinctive than the stars of pop music as a result of this. The fact that so many rock music videos picture the band performing may be merely to draw attention to these personalities and presences. As a result of this, rock videos are usually dissonant with the themes and ideas of the song lyrics having little to do with either. Compare this to the trends found in most pop songs, such as Katy Perry's Raw or Michael Jackson's Smooth Criminal. Here the performer still performs, Katy Perry sings and Michael Jackson dances, but they do so within the context of a large overarching narrative, one that reflects the nature and themes of the song. For example, the song Raw makes use of the term raw in the chorus, a term often associated intensely with not only power and dominance, but also animals. Both of these are represented throughout the video. The song takes place in the jungle and Perry's main adversary is a tiger. Once again, the video and song are connected, as tigers, being large, powerful predators, are famous for roaring. Perry's character arc also reflects this. She goes from being a hapless traveller lost in an alien and deadly environment to a kind of female Tarzan. With a slight change in colour, this can become a rather dark tale, one of lost humanity, something which would directly contradict the nature, tone and target audience of the primary song, and that would contradict Goodwin's own theory, which states that music videos must advertise the song as well. Instead, the video makes use of bright colours like green, pink and yellow, as well as humour, albeit cringeworthy humour, and a degree of voyeurism, all to maintain a light, poppy tone. And there are also similarities between the video and the song lyrics. The first line of the lyrics state, "I used to bite my tongue and hold my breath, scared to rock the boat and make a mess." This is similar to Perry's status at the start of the video, where she's helpless and unsure of herself, lost, confused and weak in her new environment, unsure where to step and scared to rock the boat. Then in the next verse, the nature of the lyrics change, saying, "You hear my voice, you hear that sound, like thunder gonna shake the ground." Instantly, this sounds more powerful, dignified. Her use of the word thunder amplifies her strength and dominance, and mirrors her adaptation and change in the video, where she grows used to her new environment, and grows close to dominating, implied by her swinging from tree to tree, like the aforementioned female Tarzan. Here the relationship between lyrics and visuals is very much positive. The video illustrates and amplifies the lyrics by placing them into a much wider context. Another way to do this is through the process of intertextuality, which Goodman himself mentions in his book. This is achieved quite well in the Skyfall video by Adele. The video is used as a direct trailer for the film of the same name, whereas the other videos both illustrated and amplify the nature and meaning of the song lyrics, Skyfall merely amplifies the lyrics, using imagery that neatly mirrors the tone of the lyrics, allowing the viewer's prior knowledge of the film series to fill in the blanks, James Bond being a well-established franchise with a long-standing and well-populated following. For example, the lyrics of the song deal with an almost apocalyptic scenario, one implied by the title itself, Skyfall. It suggests the sky is falling, an event both catastrophic and highly unlikely. It's something that for years has been considered the ultimate apocalypse by religious sects. This is mirrored in the video, as it features James Bond in climates of intense danger, also implied by the presence of weaponry, explosions, his serious facial expression throughout the video, and the fact that he's often pictured running towards or away from something, an action that implies haste, danger, and intensity. However, in an act Goodwin describes as disjuncture, the video contrasts directly with the speed of the song itself. Running, explosions, fistfights, and gunfights are usually used in fast songs to mirror the violence and hysteria of such actions. The video itself, however, is very slow, and the action is broken up by drawn-out cuts. Moreover, the lyrics of the song are written as if planning for some kind of event, something illustrated by the line, "When it crumbles, we will stand tall, face it all together." The video itself seems to take place during a cataclysmic event, then to all the explosions and fighting. The slow cuts, however, do focus the viewer on perhaps the most powerful aspect of the song, Adele's lyrics and vocal ability, as there is nothing too visually demanding of a track in the song. The video supports the song, not the other way around. This is all done whilst advertising the film itself, displaying its more exciting aspects and infusing it with a great deal of drama, through the slow cuts which place emphasis on facial expressions and body language, simply by allowing the viewer to see and appreciate them. This creates not only drama, but ambiguity. Through body language and facial expressions, the viewer can tell that the scenario is tense and dangerous. They have no idea who the characters are, with the exception of standouts like Q or Bond himself, or why they're in the situation they're in, which makes them want to find out more. Because extreme situations like this is where all great adventure fiction sprouts from. All this is achieved without compromising the music itself, adhering to Goodman's theory that the video should support the music, not the other way around. The aforementioned slow cuts do speed up alongside the song, which soon increases in tempo and volume to create a heightened sense of drama and tension, as the faster speed and volume suggests danger to a greater degree. This creates a juxtaposition. Since the cuts were so slow at the start of the video, the slightly faster cuts here seem much faster than they actually are, conveying a sense of drama much more effectively. Had the video been faster out, this effect would have been lost. So by varying the tempo of the video, the producer can manipulate the viewer's emotions and thoughts.